Way back in 2003, when I was a young child, I was watching a show on Discovery Kids where a scientist would answer questions that kids sent in. I don't remember the exact question, but some kid asked about a mammoth found preserved in ice. And the scientist guy, I think he was a scientist, he was wearing a lab coat, talked about cloning a mammoth and how in a few years we might have mammoth clones. Well, it's been nearly 20 years, and... it's not like there was one offhand mention in the early 2000s followed by radio silence. I feel like the idea of cloning mammoths has always been around, and it comes up every few years. So my question is, what is the holdup here? Where are the mammoth clones? Yeah, this is what we want. Now, there are more than just a few species of mammoth. Research is constantly updating, but right now it seems like there are about 10 recognized species. They came in a variety of sizes, with the smallest being the dwarf mammoth, Mammothus creticus, that was from the Greek island of Crete, and was 1 meter tall and weighed 300 kilos. The largest was the steppe mammoth, that reached a height of up to 4.5 meters at the shoulder, with tusks extending as long as 4.9 meters, and probably weighed somewhere between 10 to 14 tons. Putting that into context, an African bull elephant can grow up to 3.9 meters at the shoulder and weigh up to 7 tons. Despite the closeness in size, mammoths are actually more closely related to Asian elephants than African elephants. Moreover, Asian elephants and mammoths are more closely related than Asian elephants and African elephants. It's sort of an important point, as Indian elephants will need to play a role in bringing mammoths back. So how do we bring them back? There are actually a few different ways. First is actual cloning, i.e. take the egg of a female elephant, take out the nucleus and replace it with the nucleus from a woolly mammoth, and then the calf would have the genes of a woolly mammoth. Researchers at the Kyoto University of Japan did plan on doing this, but to date we haven't found a viable mammoth cell. And apparently most scientists think that a cell wouldn't survive the frozen areas where we find the best preserved mammoths. So this might not be very promising. Another method might be AI, or artificial insemination. Take an egg and combine it with a sperm cell from a frozen woolly mammoth. Then the elephant should give birth to a hybrid. If you make enough hybrids and breed them, after some generations you could get a mostly pure mammoth. Now, whether or not the embryo could survive the gestation period, which lasts 2 years, is unknown. But that's not the main problem. The big problem is that after deep freezing, sperm cells from mammals only last 15 years. So I guess that method has to be thrown out the window too. The third, and perhaps most promising method, is gene editing. Some teams are working on taking DNA from frozen mammoth carcasses and replacing the elephant genes with woolly mammoth genes. The resulting animal would still be more of an elephant, but with some mammoth traits, like long hair, small ears, extra fat, and warmer blood. Some have referred to the potential creature as a mammophant. One of the big names in this field is George M. Church. He's an American geneticist, molecular engineer, and chemist. In 2015, he and his team were able to copy some woolly mammoth genes into the genome of an Asian elephant. In September 2021, Church and his team launched a startup called Colossal. They raised $15 million in funds, and their mission is to bring back the woolly mammoth. Or to make the mammophant, I guess. Now, $15 million is a lot of money, but is it enough to fund a big project like this? Well, according to Church, $15 million would likely be enough to produce an embryo. Getting to a calf will require more funds. He estimates that we could have a living specimen in a few years. Heard that before, pal. But to be more precise, he said within about 6 years. So, mark your calendars, I guess. However, so far we've been preoccupied with whether or not we could, rather than whether or not we should. A few concerns have been raised in regards to bringing back a mammoth. For one, elephants and mammoths are pretty social animals, so bringing back a few, or even just one, could be cruel for an animal that needs to be in a group. Some feel that all the time and money and other resources should be going into protecting endangered elephants instead. We also don't know if the embryo will survive or what a hybrid calf needs to have a healthy life. Are these things being accounted for? Well, you can read more about the plans on the Colossal website, which is pretty well designed, I have to say. Going through the pages, we can find out more about the plans to bring back a mammoth, such as, apparently they are using African elephants to eliminate extra pressure on Asian elephants. According to the website, African elephants are threatened while Asian elephants are endangered. Aren't they both endangered? But also, African elephants are bigger, so it might be easier for one of them to deliver an embryo. But anyway, going back to whether or not we should, one of the reasons they list on the website for bringing back the mammoth is to combat climate change. Apparently, when the mammoths went extinct thousands of years ago, a bunch of shrubs and plants grew over what was previously grassland. If the mammoths came back, they would trample shrubs, knock over trees, and fertilize the grass. Grassland might reflect more light and therefore keep the ground cooler. On the site, it also says the work could help save modern-day elephants from extinction. Perhaps the technology of de-extinction could be used to bring back more species in the future, even species that are alive today that might go extinct in a few years. Hard to say, really. I wonder how many mammoths you need to make a serious dent in the grasslands. And also, I haven't seen this mentioned anywhere, but if the mammoths have large ivory tusks, will they need protection from poachers too? So what do you think? Should we do it?